Dear friends, thank you for joining us once again. Well, tomorrow and this weekend we celebrate Canada's holiday, Canada's birthday, 155 years. For us as Canadians, it is something for us to take pride in, to be grateful for. And just being with new parishioners lately who have come from Syria, who have come from India, and watching them and their photographs as they are enrolled as Canadians is such a wonderful thing to see. So what makes for a good citizen? What makes for a good person of faith in terms of how they can work with each other? And I've given a lot of thought to that, and my thoughts continue to crystallize on that. But a good citizen of Canada is someone who desires an honest leadership, who desires to engage in the process of making our country great with honesty, with the support from every people of every nation, of every faith, and almost all those people committing to being open to a freedom of all people from all nations and not allowing any one group to have say over another group. I suppose that would not surprise us as people of faith, because that's exactly how Jesus thinks. He treats everyone with equality, equal dignity, and invites all of us to speak our truth as he teaches us the truth. When Jesus talks about love, he means we have to love one another as the Father loves us, as God loves us. That doesn't mean we spend time with everybody. It means that we have to be open to all the incredible people that the Lord brings into our lives, into our neighborhoods. And we have to pray and support them by our honesty, by speaking out the truth, by being people this country needs. And I think like every other country in the world, our country needs us to speak and to be witnesses of what we want our country to become. So this weekend we give thanks and praise to God for we have an incredible country to live in, to be part of, to be citizens of. And we invite, and of course those of you who may be from abroad, please come to Canada when you can. We have to get our immigration system pumped up again. To keep inviting, we're waiting for people to come from Syria. We're waiting for people to come from other places, including from the Ukraine. So we want to do that. But let us be people of love, of welcome, of mercy, and of kindness to all.